First, praise my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I would say with blue ball, which is more physical than anything. I just call it keeping. Today was totally different. They brought the game to us initially. They were more physical. They played really fast. And I think they kind of surprised us a little bit, even on makes and misses. They were pushing the ball, getting out in transition, getting some easy ones in the basket. They shot about two or three throws in the first quarter. So it was 16 in the first quarter. So that was their game plan, to come in and get us a foul trouble, push the pace a little bit. You know, but that kind of played into our favor a little bit, and how we wanted to play.
Brad, I was just hoping you could put into words the feelings that were going through your head at the 5-minute mark when you walked to the bench, as opposed to watching John score that layup around the 2-minute mark.
Yeah, when they initially called me for my six, I was beyond emotional, beyond mad, frustrated. Pretty much any synonym you can have on that list. And I really honestly thought they were going to keep me out of the game because I was so mad. But I was happy that they didn't do that. I just kind of gathered my emotions, gathered my thoughts, and told my team that we were going to win across. I knew, especially if we got Johnston in the game, you know, I love our chances. Did a great job beating guys, icing the game, a nice jumper in the corner, and doing whatever, and getting stops, you know. So there was definitely a maturity level that I hit in the face of adversity that I had to overcome, and just gathering myself and being a leader and being vocal and keeping everybody encouraged in the game.
Right. Would the official explain why he called that foul?
No. No, he wouldn't explain it. No, there was no explaining to do. You know, it just was what it was. My teammates wouldn't even let me argue with him. So, you know, he made the call. I can't go back and change it. You know, we won on top of that, so that's all that mattered.
John, Brad, this is for the both of you. You use the word, Brad, adversity. But to the both of you, what does it mean when you can lose a player like yourself and then go the last 5.5 minutes and pull out a playoff game that you know you have to have?
Really just having trust. I mean, just having trust in my other teammates, knowing that he had it going for us. He was leading the score for us, just being aggressive. But we've been in situations with me being on the court dealing with injuries and Brad being having to be the guy, and vice versa. So I think all those guys just felt confidence. We just took on the challenge of getting stops as much as possible and just trying to score the ball.
How important is it for
your teammates
to not only be physical but aggressive in this game four?
The same mindset we had coming into game 3, we gotta have that same type of focus going to game 5, knowing their crowd's going to be into it, knowing they're going to try to use that as much as possible. But at the same time, we gotta do a better job just not trying to get in foul trouble. I mean, it's kind of easy shit to do, but we're playing so aggressive, we're playing so hard. You're trying to provide the air loose ball, every possession counts and matters in the playoffs, and you're trying to get put in a bad situation. I mean, I feel like the last 2 calls he had was kind of the same type of day in game 3. Keep got in foul trouble early, but we just got to go out there and play hard. We know what we can do to beat this team. We know what we got to do to stop this team.
John, going down the stretch in the absence of Bradley, can you talk about your leadership scoring 10 of the last 14 points? What do you think?
Just going and tackling. Even when Brad's in the game, he's telling me to be aggressive, but at the same time, I'm trying to keep him going and play my game. That's get my teammates involved and trying to make the job easy for those guys. And they're knocking down shots and cut for me. I'm easy to get my opportunity to score the ball. But when Brad went out, I knew I had to do whatever it took. Guarding DeRozan, making plays, scoring the ball, the passing the ball. I just wanted to do whatever so we can advance to game 5, tie 2-2.
Either one of you, in the fourth quarter, how tough was it, and how without Beal for them, but I mean to be able to deal with Wall and what happened in the last 5.5 minutes of that?
We got on the road. We got a rhythm. We became aggressive. John got aggressive. Did some big shots for him. We can execute. Myself, I took some bad shots. I led up to them, getting on the transition, getting some easy buckets. Put them on the free throw line. You know, they executed, we couldn't get a stop, and we couldn't get a bucket.
DeMar, do you think this loss was a product of something that Washington did, or
an outcome of maybe some breakdowns on the team tap you have?
I think we had 18 turnovers. Can't happen. You know, can't happen. You know, I think we got stagnant. Like I said, I took some bad shots that I wish I could have it back, but you know, just gotta watch film, understand what we gotta do. Me and him understand how much better we have to be, especially late game situation.
Kyle, what did you see in that last 5 minutes off from their defense in particular?
They were aggressive, but you know, we missed some layups, shots, and we passed a few shots. We worked as we didn't move the ball as well. We got just stacked. We just got to continue to play our offense. When we swing it, it stays mentally strong.
Kyle, to that point, how much is their switching, which they weren't doing as much of early in the series, having an impact on the stack?
I mean, the switching is definitely changing, but you know, we're still getting off of it, we're still getting in the paint, we're still drive kicking, swinging. You know, when they're making the runs and they're switching, we still got to play our game. We still got to get one big down, play our offense. I think today we didn't